The EcoSport may have started the compact SUV craze in India, but soon enough, it started feeling dated once rivals jumped in. Now, Ford wants its crown back and has introduced a thoroughly updated version of its small SUV. What's good? What's not? Is it better than its predecessor? Let's find out by looking at the hits and misses. The EcoSport is one of the few cars in the segment that looks like a scaled-down SUV and not a hatchback on stilts. Design elements like the large Ford family grille, the projector headlamps with daytime running lamps, and the spare wheel on the boot look aggressive and purposeful. On the inside too, things are simple, clean, functional, but attractive. That gets a big thumbs up from us. We are glad Ford has ditched the tiny screen and loads of buttons in favor of a simple touchscreen. The 8-inch screen isn't just the biggest in its class, it's also among the best to use. It's quick to respond to inputs and the user interface is easy to get used to as well. Plus, it gets Android Auto, Apple CarPlay, and Ford's Sync 3 tech that lets you install some apps. In most new age cars, base variants come poorly equipped just to get an aggressive entry price. But that's not the case with the EcoSport. Even in the base ambient version, the SUV gets all the necessary features, including dual airbags, ABS, a 4-speaker audio system, front and rear power windows, and more. To know more about what each variant offers, head to our Variants Explained story by hitting the link above. The new petrol engine feels right at home in the EcoSport. With 123 PS on tap, the 3-cylinder engine is adept for city commuting. Moreover, you get the choice of a 6-speed torque converter automatic with the petrol engine for that added bit of convenience. On the other hand, the 110 PS diesel motor is the fun one. It offers explosive performance and is a motor you can enjoy pushing a bit. Evidently, the EcoSport has come a long way, and things have indeed gotten better with the update. But not all is well. So what could have been better in the Ford EcoSport facelift? We'll get to that in just a moment. But if you've liked this video so far, do hit the subscribe button below for more such content. Despite the extensive update, the EcoSport's diesel motor doesn't come paired with an automatic transmission. The Mahindra TUV 300 and the Nuvo Sport get a diesel auto drivetrain, while Tata is expected to equip the Nexon with an automatic early next year. This is a market Ford cannot afford to ignore. Ford has worked on the seats in the new EcoSport. They're wider and a bit more supportive now. However, the space on offer still continues to be just about average. The cabin is narrow, which means seating 3 adults at the back is quite the squeeze. While we had no issues with the headroom, some more knee room would have made the EcoSport a better family car. The new interior definitely looks better, but it has brought its own set of problems. For instance, the central AC vents are placed a bit too low, which causes them to chill your left hand while driving. The central armrest is also positioned a bit low, which makes it hard for the front passenger to use it. Plus, it doesn't slide ahead, making it all the more unusable. Also, the boot door still opens towards the left when it should have been the other way around. Agree or disagree with any of the points raised? Let us know what your thoughts on the updated Ford EcoSport are, and don't forget to give this video a thumbs up if you liked it.